the week on Green 960.
Here's Sebastian Kunz.
So who really goes to a seminar about a 40-year-old fictional television show and the modern science of studying humanity, especially when it takes place in the middle of the WonderCon comic book convention, when there's likely to be something a bit more fun than a Star Trek and Anthropology lecture? Well, the answer is, so many people went, it was standing room only at Moscone Center last Saturday night in San Francisco, and it wasn't even what you might think of as the usual nerds.
We talk about this kind of stuff with each other all the time, so it's nice to have it in an open forum and we not feel so isolated. There's other people that, you know, have differing opinions that can, you know, can argue back and forth.
This guy and his female companion, by the way, attended the seminar. What made him stand out was his costume. Only black underwear and blue body paint everywhere else, from the tip of his bald cap to the blue nail polish on his toes.
Okay, so my first question is, who are you?
I'm Dr. Manhattan, and she's the Silk Spectre from The Watchmen.
Got it.
The graphic novel and film.
The Watchmen film, in fact, debuts in theaters over this weekend, so that makes this very timely, but it takes all kinds, even humans, for instance. Chelsea Cooper is from Santa Rosa, but she's currently a senior at UCLA, writing her thesis on the very topic of Star Trek and science.
I was actually in my introductory sociology course, and I was reading Emile Durkheim, and I was really sick of it because it was school, and I was tired. And so I was flipping through the channels, and I found this documentary on the History Channel called Star Trek Beyond the Final Frontier. And it was talking about the Christie's auction that happened in October of 2007, where Christie's thought it would be, you know, maybe, you know, a little bit of money, and it ended up being about four times as much money as they thought. They got $3.7 million. And they had all of these interviews with these stars, and they were talking about how, you know, fans come to them and ask them to bless their children, and, you know, people form communities, and they have friends that they see at every single convention. And I was like, you know, this sounds really familiar. And so I approached my professor, and luckily he was a Trekkie too, and he let me write my project on it for the functionalism section of our class. And I wrote a 7-page paper, and I had so much more to say. So I submitted the topic, and now I'm writing about a 40 to 50 page thesis on it.
And from her sociological perspective, Cooper says Star Trek has a uniquely positive forecast for where humanity's going.
I think that America definitely does need it because of what we were talking about, that we don't have any positive views of the future. Anything involving technology is, you know, the Terminator, Judgment Day, or, you know, iRobot, where everything breaks loose when it was supposed to be good.
And not only does Star Trek give us that highly optimistic view of the future, and the cool gadgets and toys, by the way, but it also continues to challenge us culturally.
I mean, the first interracial kiss was on Star Trek. He really pushed some boundaries, and it was very reflective of the culture at the time. Civil rights movement was happening, you know, it was starting, but that sort of thing. And then in turn, Star Trek influences people in society, and then they turn around and write to the studio.
That, of course, was television's first ever interracial kiss on Star Trek. As Uhura actress Nichelle Nichols described it, the races have been kissing each other since time immemorial. The girl dressed as the Silk Spectre says with a seminar like this and a new film coming out this summer, Star Trek entertains and educates as much as ever.
I'm hoping that at the next convention that we go to, that there will be more Star Trek costumes with the new movie coming out, and with that series getting more breathed into it.
Her real name is Kenyon Appleby, by the way, and her companion, the blue guy, Dr. Manhattan, portrayed by Bobby Martinez, sort of echoed an Obama campaign message.
There's an intrinsic value in having hope for the future. Roddenberry tapped into it in the 60s, and he pushed it ahead. He kept, you know, fighting it, breathed new life into the 80s, carried it through the 90s, and if there's any time we need hope more, is now.
So the Moscone Center was, in fact, kind of geek central, with many of the participants freely admitting that, but it's the ultimate kind of a diversity acceptance. The example, when a girl in the audience accidentally had her lightsaber go off during the lecture, the very clearly defined Star Trek lecture, that is, everyone was tolerant. Those Star Wars weapons, you see, just don't have a vibrate setting. By the way, video of my interview with the blue guy up at green960.com. Up next, homesteading on the seafloor. It's all on the week on Green 960.